was a beat behind the music of our whole family, you know. It was really wonderful. And he was always who he was, you know. What were the errors with him? He was very, very authentic.
Are you going to play a, you going to have a video?
Oh, yeah. I have a video of the whole thing.
Really?
We'll have it up on the first website. It'll take me a while.
Are you going to show it tonight?
Oh, no. Oh! Colorado. They had it, but they decided it'd be destroyed. But we can get it. I have the, you'll enjoy it. I'll give you a copy.
I was talking about that last night, you know, because when Joe Melvin got up, you know, and he was talking about wanting to be part of the Pointless Sisters, I said, and here's a guy that has to travel 3,000 miles to lament the fact that he couldn't even get a chance to wear a bra.
I'd show you the boots.
Yeah, that's it.
You don't like that stuff.
This looks good, doesn't it?
Poison Company Z.
I won't talk about the movie that has the name Chatterley in it, but you know, the guy who was the funniest guy I've ever been around, as you all know. I'll tell you all the story. I was in third grade. I got called to the principal's office, and my mom and dad had to go to the principal's office. I was telling off-color jokes in the third grade. Guess where I learned the jokes? Okay? I behave very similarly to Ron. I can't help it. I'm a drummer. We are different. The one thing about Ron that I love, though, was that he could definitely make an entire room have fun. We went on a cruise through Hawaii, and he had the whole boat as his best friend by the end of the cruise. You know, we could go on and on about stories of Ron. I think the best thing is that he's touched many lives. He definitely touched my life. He gave me something that I long for and live for. You know, playing music and being happy and joyous and being with other people. You know, Ryan, I got to tell you a story, Ryan. Jake came up, my son, he wanted to be a drummer, like his dad. And I went, no, please, no, don't be a drummer. And when he was a freshman in high school, he said, Dad, I don't want to play the drums anymore. And I said, yes. And I know why your dad made you play the trombone, because being a drummer is not fun. You can't play at your dad's funeral when you're a drummer. Your trombone work is way more spectacular. It's very musical. You can play it all the time, and you're so good at it. I'm really glad your dad was supposed to stop now. Okay, we got an announcement. Pick up pizza order number 3, please. Pizza order number 3.
We have a beautiful book up here on this table that was supposed to be by the door. And it's a commemorative book of Frank Sinatra's 100 years, and you know how Ron loves Sinatra. So please come up and use the Sharpie pens and make a memory for Ron, or that you have of Ron. Kind of like what we did at the 16th birthday, okay? Dudley, you going first?
Mine is only going to take 30 seconds. So, I was going to go fly fishing with my girlfriends, but I didn't know how to fly fish. So Ron swimming up the street, so I called Ron, come down and teach me how to fly fish. So we're in the driveway. So Ron, teach me how to fly fish. He says, there's only one thing you need to know. It's bada bing, bada bang. Bada bing, bada bang. And that's it. I learned how to fly fish.
Did you catch any fish?
So I gotta start all over again. I'm Chris. I was one of the first employees of RPA. I was a deadbeat drummer out of high school with no life and no career, and so Ron and Sue and Mike saw fit to give me some employment. So I got to work for RPA. I got to sweep a whole bunch of Teradata floors, and it was really cool. You know, one of the things that Ron was always good about with Dave and me was providing good direction, and it was a great part of my life being able to spend so much time with Ron. So some of the people that have known RPA or worked with RPA, you look kind of familiar because I probably swept the floor. The other thing that I wanted to mention was golfing with Ron. So I got to play golf with Ron a couple times, and we played Wood Ranch once, and Ron told us to bring up a lot of golf balls, and after after we played with my dad and Dave and myself, and after the first nine, we ran out of balls. I used a dozen balls at Wood Ranch. So if you see some Slazenger balls at Wood Ranch, they're mine. Yeah, those were expensive. The last thing that I want to mention, and I hope you guys are kind of hearing this, but my mom and Aunt Sue, one of the reasons that we're close to Ron and Sue and Ryan and their family and the Poulsons is because of my mom and Aunt Sue and their relationship. You probably all know all too much how close my mom and Sue are. And it was a real blessing for my mom. And Sue is an absolutely amazing woman. Anybody that has had to put up with my mom and me and Dave is an amazing woman. I'd really like for y'all to just continue on your love fest with Sue. And I know that Ryan and Gracie have a great life plan for them as well. I just appreciate y'all taking time and caring for my family so much. So, thanks. Have a good evening. Make sure that you drive safely going home. And God bless y'all.
And it's really directed so much at Sue and Ryan, because they had a very difficult situation to deal with for a long time, which we all shared. That's okay. In any event, we all shared in that situation. But Sue and Ryan certainly, that's tough duty. But I did share with Ryan right after we heard the word. I came down and went out to see Ryan perform here at Westlake, and I shared this with him. And I think it's important because Craig touched on it at the service, and so we all know. I could tell you all kinds of goofy jokes about Ron, things that he'd done, and what a goofball, and makes all that. But he made a real difference in everyone's life. In my particular case, it is kind of a funny story. In fact, the Winters were involved in this because they were very involved in the MS charities at the time. And Ron was wanting me to get involved with it. And I was, willing to go to a party and, spend the money for the dinner and that sort of thing. And he sat me down and said, "No, that's not what I'm talking about." He says, "You," and he pointed right at me. He says, "You need to give more. You don't give enough." And I was kind of taken back, and I said, "What do you mean I don't give enough? I do this, I do that." He says, "No, you don't get it. You don't give enough." And we talked about it, and he was so right. And it truly changed my life. And even getting involved in the church, in the Bible, in Jesus Christ, and Barbara, so much of that, we owe all the Ron Poulson. So how much better can it be for that? And for that I say, bada bing!
Bada bing!
Bada!
Ron came in to play, right. A person, yes.
picture. What do you want to say about Ron?
I miss him. Like, I didn't really know Ron like before, like everyone else did, but I kind of got to see a really mellow version of him. Like, you know, going over golfing with him and like playing board games and stuff. It's just, he really was the gentle kind of person everyone says he is, and I miss him.
I'm sure he misses you. He was such an authentic guy.
We joined the church 20 years ago, and he was like a driving force in everything.
Was. Yeah, I was thinking of him playing the drum. He was like the sound behind it, you know? Always willing to volunteer wherever he was needed.
I know.
To drive so many things.
He's the one that pulled us in, you know?
Yeah.
Like, awesome. It's so sad that he's not here.
Yeah, it was very powerful to be here.
Yeah.
And it's amazing what Sue has done. She's been such a strong person in handling this. That's a long time. A long goodbye. Yeah. That's the hard part. But it seems like yesterday. It still does. When you hear the stories.
It does seem so vivid. Like it just happened and I can't believe it.
I couldn't look at Stan, was like shaking. I could feel him shaking and crying. I'm like, am I out?
A lot of tears, well earned.